Today we pray this powerful prayer about God and His mercy. The prayer is that God would increase and multiply His mercy upon us so that we might pass through things temporal and lose not the things eternal. That's the prayer. It's all about mercy, isn't it? Life in Christ with God at our side. Mercy is like water, really. You know, both are necessities of life. We take water for granted oftentimes, unless we're really parched and our throat is dry. And then we look around and we have some water and we drink it and everything is fine once again. Now that's kind of like God's mercy. We take it for granted oftentimes until our soul is parched and dried. And then we realize that somehow or another in our life, the predicaments and the tribulations. And then we seek and find God's mercy. We receive it and are subsequently strengthened and satiated and immersed in His mercy. And then we share that mercy with other people in life. Jesus is the definitive example statement of God's mercy. Now, you might wonder, or maybe you have wondered in your life at one time or another, why did God do such a thing as the incarnation? Why did He have to go to those such extreme in order to help us? Well, it's because that's what it took, not only to get our attention, but also to get our souls back into His eternal presence. It took a grand statement. It was the only way that we would respond appropriately. But also, number two, the incarnation declares very powerfully and in the flesh, okay? Declares very powerfully that God is not wrathful. He has no wrath for us. On the contrary, Jesus is God's eternal covenant that gives us, and which says to us, really, I love you so much that I will do anything in order to stop you from squandering your life in sin. That's the declaration of Christ Jesus. You see, we are called to be merciful in our life. That's the whole of the message for this day. Now, how do we do it? Well, the answer lies in an oftentimes neglected portion of the Lord's Prayer. I think you know what it is. We'll say it later on. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Do we really want God to forgive us as we forgive others? You bet we do. It's the only way to wholeness and sanctity. Gregory of Nyssa, a champion of the faith centuries ago, put it this way: if we're not to lie when we call ourselves Christians, he said, we must bear witness to it by our way of life. That's good. Not just saying things, but living them, doing them. Now, it is a truth that life is essentially very simple. We pile on layers upon layers of this, that, and the other thing. But life is simple. If we want to go from point A to B, we look at a map. If we want to live life so that we pass through things temporal and lose not the things eternal, we ask for and then embrace when we receive mercy, and then we share it in our life with others. And we do that because we cannot ask from God something that we are unwilling to give to our neighbor. It's as simple as that, isn't it? And that's what Jesus was speaking of in today's gospel narrative, beholding the tiny little sliver, the mote, of wood in our brother's eye, while ignoring the old growth redwood log, otherwise known as beam, in our own. And here's some really great news. It's real good news. God's mercy is not just at work to save us from sin. It also readjusts this thing, the experience of suffering that we all have. Since the fall, suffering has been a synonym for life. It's just part of life in this fallen world. And yet, along with all the pain and the anguish and sometimes even despair, there is within us that great gift that alleviates, dissipates the power of our suffering. What is that? It is the hope of eternal life in the presence of God. We're told about that in the epistle for this day. There will be a day when God wipes away all our tears. The epistle tells us, I reckon that all that the sufferings of this present time are not worthy to be compared with the glory which shall be revealed in us through Christ Jesus our Lord. We get a little bit of that glory now when we love God and our neighbor, when we are merciful with one another. And then we get the whole kit and caboodle of it in life with God in the end. God's mercy is everlasting.